Welcome to Erotech Solutions. This is Shanan. I want to explain, in continuation with previous instruction set, data transfer from 8051 controller. This is your next instruction set, arithmetic operations. So to do arithmetic operations with assembly language in 8051 microcontroller, you have to follow the standard instruction set. So this is your complete instruction set to do your addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, increment and decrement operations. So this instruction set will give you the possibilities in between what operands you can try addition operation, you can do subtraction operation, you can do multiplication, you can do division and increment decrement. So whereas in arithmetic operations, maximum cases your result is going to save in accumulator, most of the cases. So as from CPU, in all ALU operations, ALU stands for arithmetic and logical operations, so your accumulator is the destination register most case. And here ADD A, RR, ADD is the mnemonic and A, RR, these two are operands, means addition operation between accumulator and any general purpose registers from R0 to R7. You can do addition operation between accumulator and any general purpose register values. So by doing addition operation between these two numbers, again your result is going to save in accumulator. And also one more possibility with add instruction, accumulator with RAM location value. So whatever the address you are giving here, the value present in that location is added with your accumulator and result is going to save in accumulator. The same way, accumulator with pointer register value and accumulator with direct constant value. Hash n means 1 byte constant value. So in all these cases, your destination is accumulator. Again, there are the same sequence, add C. So from arithmetic operations, you have to take care of this flag bits. So there are carry, auxiliary carry and overflow. So C stands for carry, OV stands for overflow and auxiliary carry is here again one more flag bit. All these are flags, but depends on their individual positions you are calling with different names. I'll explain you what is auxiliary carry and what is overflow and what is carry. So the possibility with this add C is, if you are adding only two numbers, there is no issue and no need to consider your flags. But if you are trying to do sequence numbers addition, then you have to take care of your carry flag. So you need to forward your carry flag with the next result, otherwise your answer goes wrong. So again, they are giving possibilities with along with carry flag, accumulator with RR, which means any general purpose register value, accumulator with address location value, accumulator with pointer register value, accumulator with constant value, and DAA, which means decimal adjust after addition. So this instruction will keep your answer in numbers, not in hexa characters, because every answer will come in hexadecimal format. So hexadecimal number system contains numbers from 0 to F. But whenever you got result as characters, suppose I am giving one example, some 6EAH. So within the 6EAH, A is a character, 6 is a number. So your decimal adjust after addition instruction will make you that A is adds with 6. And why they are adding with 6? From A to F, you have 6 numbers. If you are adding with 6, then anyway your answer comes to numbers. That is the only intention, decimal adjust after addition, which works on accumulator value. If accumulator value contains LSB part is hexadecimal character, or MSB part, if it contains hexadecimal character in LSB part, it adds with 06. If your accumulator contains hexadecimal character in MSB part, which means A to F, so it adds with 60H. Suppose your accumulator contains both are characters, So it adds with 66H. The intention is very clear. It keeps your numbers in on your value in 0 to 9 numbers. That is your decimal adjust after addition. And DECA, which means decrement accumulator value by 1. Decrement RR, which means any general purpose register value you can decrement by 1 by using this syntax. And decrement ADD, which decrements your address location value by 1. Not address, whatever the value present in this address, it decrements by 1. And decrement pointer register, it decrements your pointer register value by 1. And DIVAB, which means division operation with A and B. So if you are trying to do division between A and B, there are two answers for us. One is quotient and other one is remainder. But division operation possible between only A and B registers. Don't use other operands for division. Other operands means no registers as general purpose registers, no constant values in the instruction, no address locations in the instruction. And increment A, INCA, which means increment accumulator value by 1. And increment general purpose register value by 1. Increment address location value by 1. Increment pointer register value by 1. And increment DPTR, which means data pointer, which is 16 bit register, it increments by 1. And MUL. MUL is also possible between only A and B registers. Don't use other operands as, don't use other operand, other registers or any other address locations as operands. That's your multiplication. And don't use even comma, special character between two operands. And SUBB, which is subtraction with borrow, which means subtraction with borrow, which is possible between A and register, A and address location value, accumulator with pointer register value, accumulator with constant value. So most of the cases your destination is accumulator. And what is this bytes column? So this bytes column, which clearly tells us for each instruction how many opcodes and how many ROM locations it occupies from the program memory. So as per count, it occupies number of ROM locations from your ROM memory from the controller. And cycles, which is machine cycles. So machine cycle is the time taken to execute an instruction is called machine cycle. How many machine cycle it takes to execute these particular instructions? So machine cycle has three stages: fetch, decode and execute. And this last column, which is for flags. So if you are applying this particular operation in program, then these flags got affected as per your numbers. So RR means any general purpose register you can take as a operand. RP means pointer register. In assembly language, as pointer registers, you can use only R0 and R1 from 8051. And ADD stands for RAM address, you can choose from 00 to 7FH. And hash n means 1 byte constant value. Now, this is your addition truth table. If you are trying to do addition operation between two binary numbers, you will get two answers. One is sum and other one is carry. For 00, your answer sum is 0 and carry 0. For 01 case, sum 1, carry 0. For 10, sum 1, carry 0. If you are doing addition operation between two binary bits as 11, sum 0, carry 1. Now, I am trying to add the 78H and 96H. So, for this, you will get carry flag as 1. So, from this 8-bit answer, from this previous column flags. So all are flag bits, but depends on their individual positions, you are calling with different names. So auxiliary carry, this is also carry flag, but if you get carry flag across D4 position. So from this number, these 4 bits are LSB part and these 4 bits are MSB part. If you are forwarding your carry flag from LSB side to MSB side, then your auxiliary carry becomes 1. Otherwise, auxiliary carry flag remains 0. And overflow, whenever you got carry flag at D7 position, then overflow becomes 1. And if you got carry flag after D7 position, your carry becomes 1. So all your flags, carry flags, but depends on their individual positions, you are calling with different names. And what is parity? So parity allows to check from your 8-bit result how many number of ones, that is even number of ones or odd number of ones. So that's about your flag bits from 8051. Suppose I am trying to do subtraction operation. The subtraction operation is quite different than addition. So whatever the negative number you are taking, so now I require 98 minus 42, one example, which is 56 is the answer, general decimal subtraction operation. Now as a device, how it is trying to do the subtraction operation? The first number 92, which is taken as 62H, not same as 98. And for 62H, this is your BCD equivalent, 0110 0010. The second number minus 42 as 42, which is 2AH, is the equivalent hexadecimal. 16 twos are 32 and remaining 10. 10 means A. 2AH is the hexadecimal equivalent for your 42. So for this 2AH, I am writing hexadecimal equivalent. The second number, you need to find out 1's complement first. 1's complement means zeros as 1's and 1's as zeros. And the 2's complement means adding with 1 will get 2's complement answer for the second number. So this is my 2's complement result for your second number 11010110. And you need to do addition operation with this first number with this 2's complement answer. So I am trying to add, so I will get 38H. So always your answers will show in hexadecimal format, not in decimal. So if you convert your 38H into decimal, so 16 power 0, 8 into 16 power 0, 3 into 16 power 1. 16 3 is a 48 and 8 into 16 power 0. 48 plus 8, you get 56. So it matches with your regular decimal number. This is how your subtraction operation happens internally. So subtraction operation needs these to find 2's complement for your second number and do the addition operation with the first number. So you'll get your regular answers. Even multiplication means number of times addition with the same number. So I'll show you one program with this arithmetic operations between two 8-bit numbers. So I'm taking two numbers into two registers, A register with 25 and B register with 67. And I am adding A comma B, and this result I am trying to move it into 20H RAM memory location. So always your A is affected with the result whenever you are doing addition operation. So for subtraction requirement, again I will take it into this first number into A, and I will do subtraction operation with B register value. B register value remains same, no change from the value. And so again, I am moving this accumulator value into 21 because I want to use this accumulator for other requirements. Again, first number I am loading with accumulator. And doing a multiplication operation between only A and B registers. So multiplication is possible between only A and B registers. But once you multiply two 8-bit numbers, there is a chance to get 16-bit result. If you get 16-bit result, you need to use two locations of RAM memory to store your result. So how your 16-bit result is saved? First part of your result is saved in A register, which is LSB part. And MSB part of your answer is saved in B register. Anyway, after multiplication operation, your B register is replaced with MSB part of your result. And for division operation, again I need to reassign the values, and I'm trying to do division operation between A and B only, because your division and multiplication allows only A and B registers. So it never allows any other registers as operands. And even after division, you will get two answers, quotient and remainder. So I am trying to save this A with some other address 24H and remainder with 25H. I will show you output of this program with Keel Microvision IDE. So this is your Keel Microvision IDE. So it helps to cross-check your outputs. So Keel Microvision IDE is one of the most popular IDE to write the programs, to compile the programs, to debug the programs, and to create .hex files for your microcontrollers. So IDE, which itself integrated development environment, it supports all the required things: editors, assemblers, compilers, debuggers, interpreters. Now let's see the procedure how to write program in this Keel Microvision and how to compile and how to debug for your existence program. Just follow the steps. Just select project tab and choose option New Microvision Project. Now what is the project name? You can go with Arithmetic Operations. So now I am giving simply Arithmetic is my project name and click on save. Now it opens one window which is for choosing your target device on which microcontroller you are trying to work. Maybe from Atmel, maybe from Philips, maybe from Samsung. This Keel Microvision IDE supports for all these manufacturers. You can choose any one of the device from all these different manufacturer names. Now I am selecting Atmel manufacturer and click on plus mark. It will show the list of devices from this manufacturer. Now choose the specific device, which is AT89C51. Now click on OK. This is your startup code warning. It maintains all the default values of registers and memory locations. If you want to add, just click on yes and or else no. There is no issue just by clicking yes or no here. Now I am going with option no. Up to now, you selected your target device on which microcontroller you are trying to write programs. Now you need to open editor window. For that, go file tab and choose option new. Now I am taking two different numbers on A and B registers. And if you are trying to add A comma B, but the result which is saved in accumulator itself, your accumulator is required for next operations, so that I am saving my answer into some other RAM memory address. Again, I am reassigning the value. And trying to do subtraction operation because no change from B register value, it remains 12. So this subtraction result, I'll move it into some other address of RAM. And again reassigning the value for accumulator and trying to apply multiplication. But whenever you do multiplication with A and B registers, so you'll get 16-bit answer. Your B register is saved with MSB part of your answer. So your multiplication result is saved in two registers as A and B as two parts. So you need to move it into two address locations. So 22 location I'm using for higher byte, for lower byte, and higher byte I'm using 23H comma B. The same way, the division operation, which again required reassigning the numbers, the division operation also possible between only A and B registers. But once you do division operation, it will give two answers as 24h. I am trying to save this quotient of division operation with 24h, and 25h is location filled with B register. And so this is my text editor. Here I can write my program. Now go file option and use save button. So you need to save this program with proper extension. Give the program name followed by .asm extension. Program name always requires the specific extension. If you are using assembly language, save the program with .asm extension. If you write program in embedded C, you can save with .c extension. Now I written program in assembly language, so I am saving with .asm extension. Click on save. Your program is saved. So this program you have to compile with respect to target. So further, choose this target one option. Click on plus mark. You'll get source group 1. Which source file you are trying to execute with respect to target? Right click on it and choose the option add files to source group. But it will show you default source file. File of type is C. Now you need to change it to ASM. Now my assembly language program name is arithmetic, so I am selecting it and choose add button and close it. Once the program is added, you will get plus mark with source group also. To check errors and warnings in this program, for compilation go project tab and choose the option build target, or else F7 function key from the keyboard. So from this program I don't have errors and warnings. If you are a new beginner, you may do some mistakes. So proper commas between operands and space between operands and mnemonic, so that you may do mistakes. So anyway, if you do any mistake, it will show the error in the proper line. Double click on it and rectify the error and do this save and build. So these are two shortcut buttons to save the program and build the program. Now in this program I don't have errors and warnings. Let's go for debug session to cross check the output. Further, choose this debug tab and use the option start and stop debug session. This is your evolution mode. This is a trial version of your Keel Microvision. If you are using licensed one, you will never get this warning. Now so this is your disassembly code. Disassembly code will help you to know the opcodes of instructions. If you want to keep, you can keep it, otherwise you can close this disassembly window. To execute this program line by line, you need to press F11 function key from the keyboard. So the arrow marks show you in which line your execution takes place. The first line I executed so that I got the value into accumulator 65. Now B register default is 0. Once you execute this line, 12H is assigned with B register. Add A comma B, which means your 65H and 12H both are added and your result saved in 77. But where you are trying to move this 77 into 20H RAM address. So if you want to test your RAM locations, if this window is not available, go view tab and choose option memory window. So you can click this memory window, you'll get this one. But type of memory is also very important here. If you are checking with RAM memory, use letter D followed by colon and address. After giving address, use enter button. And all the default values of memory locations are zeros. But as per this line, once you execute this line, your answer 77 is moved to 20H address. I am pressing F11 now. So I received 77 into this 20H address. Again I am reassigning the value 65 to the A and B remains 12. Now I am doing subtraction operation between 65 and 12. So I got 53. So 53 is moved to next address of RAM. After 20 you will get 21H. So your 21H location is filled with subtraction result. Again, for multiplication, I am reassigning the value with A register, and B register remains 12, no change. So now I am doing multiplication between 65H and 12H. I got 1A07. 1A is the lower part of your result and 07 is the higher part of your result. So total result is 071A. So these two answers, you need to move it into 22H and 23H. Means the next location of 21. So I got 1A and 07. Even for division operation, again I am reassigning these two numbers, 65H with A and 12H with B. And division operation between A and B. So once you do this division operation, you get two answers, quotient and remainder. So what is the quotient? 05, and 0B is the remainder. So 05 is saved in 24H and 0B is saved with 25H address. So this is how you can cross check your arithmetic operations between two 8-bit numbers using assembly language program. Still, you are executing F11 from keyboard, no lines to execute your program. So after completion of your program debugging, then again go for the debug tab and choose the first option to stop your debug session. So this is how you can write the program, you can compile the program, you can debug your output by using this Keil Microvision IDE. So this is how you can cross check your answers. For more videos, please subscribe our channel from YouTube, Aerotech Solutions, and give your valuable feedback through comment. Please like our videos and share our videos to spread the knowledge to different engineering students and freshers and beginners. Thanks for watching, and we are giving training on different levels of technical engineering students. We are giving training on firmware development, IoT and device drivers. We are giving online training and also classroom training for freshers, even BTech second year, third year and final year students. We are doing hobby projects with different microcontrollers, 8-bit, 16-bit and 32-bit families. And we will work on all wireless modules, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, GSM, GPS, ZigBee, RF, and different sensors and different protocols, I2C, SPI, CAN. And even you are giving training on operating system concepts as device drivers, system programming, network programming, and kernel. So you are doing practical training on all different levels of candidates. If anyone is looking for training, please contact with this number or WhatsApp the number 9676327118. It's a guarantee placement program for completed engineering students. And we are offering internships also, paid internships for engineering students. And if you want to reach our office, please follow this address: Rajamma Towers, Jayanagar, Bhagyanagar Colony, near KPHP Metro Station, Kukatpalli, Hyderabad. For any queries, please write an email, ysnanda@aerotechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.